गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. सो टुडे विल डिस्कस अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक बिकॉज ऑफ विच लाइफ एग्जिस्ट ऑन दिस अर्थ. एंड दिस इंपॉर्टेंट फिनोमेनन इज ओनली सीन इन फीमेल्स. एंड दिस टॉपिक इज मेंस्ट्रुअल साइकिल. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल हाउ वी कैन डिफाइन दिस. सो द रिप्रोडक्टिव साइकिल इन द फीमेल प्रीमेट्स, फॉर एग्जाम्पल मंकीज, एप्स and human beings is called menstrual cycle. So this reproductive cycle is only seen in the female primates, and these primates means the monkey, chimpanzee, gorilla. Try to recall the classification of human beings. So what will be the kingdom, phylum, class, order, family, genus, species? So kingdom will be the Kingdom Animalia, Phylum Vertebrata, Class Mammalia, and Order Primates. So this primates is a order, and this primates includes the monkeys, apes, human, including the human beings. So this the reproductive cycle which occurs in the females of primates. So this reproductive cycle is known as menstrual cycle. And the first menstruation begins at the age of puberty, and it is called as menarche. So what term is given for the first reproductive cycle which occurs at the age of puberty, which is roughly around 11 to 12 years? So this is known as menarche. And the last menstrual cycle which will occurs in the any female, so that is known as menopause, and it is mainly occurs at the age of around 50 years. In human females, the menstruation is repeated at an average interval of about 28 to 29 days. So this will vary from the person to person. And the cycle of events starting from one menstruation till the next one is called menstrual cycle. So this is the around 28 days cycle of the that reproductive cycle which occurs in the human female. So this part it is representing the menstrual phase, this part it is representing the follicular phase, and this particular part it is representing the ovulatory phase, and from here to here, so this particular part it is the luteal phase. So roughly we can say that the reproductive cycle in female it is of around 28 days. So it will vary from person to person. It may be 26 days, it may be of 30 days. So one ovum is released during the middle of each menstrual cycle, and the process by which ovum is released, so that process is known as ovulation. And when this ovum will release, so it will release at the middle of the menstrual cycle. So suppose that if the reproductive cycle is of around 28 days, then what will be the middle of that cycle? So it will be 14 days. So at 14 days the one female gamete ovum will be released. If the reproductive cycle is of around 26 days, then at 13 days the ovum will be released. Now we'll study about what are the different phases of the menstrual cycle. So we can categorize the menstrual cycle or reproductive cycle into four different phases. First phase is the menstruation or menstrual phase. Second phase is the follicular phase. Third phase is the ovulation or ovulatory phase, in which the ovulation will take place. And fourth and the last phase is the luteal phase. So here this part will represent the menstrual phase. This particular part from here to here, it will represent the follicular phase. This red part, it will indicate the ovulatory phase, and this will represent the luteal phase. The cycle starts with the menstrual phase. So menstrual phase is the first phase in the reproductive cycle in female. So when menstrual flow occurs, and it lasts for around 3 to 5 days, the menstrual flow results due to the breakdown of endometrial lining of the uterus and its blood vessels, which forms liquid that comes out through the vagina. So what is the cause of this menstrual phase? So the So due to the breakdown of endometrial lining, so endometrium is the innermost lining of the uterus. So this is the uterus. So this particular part is the uterus. So this is a diagram of the human female reproductive system, and this particular part is the uterus. This is fallopian tube. So this uterus, the inner lining of the uterus, which is known as endometrium, so which becomes spongy and thick, and it get richly supplied with the blood vessel. So this inner layer of the uterus, which is known as endometrium, so it will get set off, and it will come out from the vagina as a menstrual outflow. So this is the first phase of the reproductive cycle. Menstruation only occurs if the released ovum is not fertilized. Lack of menstruation may be indicative of pregnancy. So this menstruation, it only occurs if the released ovum is not fertilized. If the fertilization takes place, if the ovum, it will get fertilized by the sperm, then this menstrual cycle, it will get stopped. So menstruation will only occurs if the released ovum is not fertilized. So we have to keep this in our mind, and lack of menstruation may indicative of the pregnancy. However, it may also be caused due to some other underlying causes like stress. So if the menstruation will not take place, it doesn't means always that the girl or woman is pregnant. It may takes place due to some disease like polycystic ovary, stress, poor health. So this may be the reason for the menstruation not to occur. The menstrual phase is followed by the follicular phase. So this follicular phase is the second phase of the reproductive cycle in female. So during this follicular phase, the primary follicles in the ovary grow to become a fully mature graafian follicle, and simultaneously the endometrium of uterus regenerates through proliferation. So this is a very important phase, which is the follicular phase. So two events are going to take place. First event is that formation of mature graafian follicle. So from primary follicle, mature graafian follicle will be formed inside the ovary. So this one will take place during the follicular phase. Second event, which will take place during the follicular phase, is the endometrium. The endometrium of the uterus, it will regenerates and through proliferation. So suppose that this is the ovary. So this primary, during the follicular phase, so this primary follicle, it will form the secondary follicle, then tertiary follicle, and finally they will form the mature graafian follicle. So this is the event which is taking place inside the ovary. Simultaneously, the inner lining of the uterus. So this is the uterus after the menstruation, after the menstrual phase. In this diagram, you can see that the endometrium, the inner lining of the uterus, it is very thin. But during follicular phase, the endometrium, again the formation of endometrium will takes place, and the endometrium, it will become thick and spongy. It will get richly supplied with the blood vessel. In this diagram, you can see. So two events are taking place simultaneously. So these changes in the ovary and the uterus are induced by change in the levels of pituitary and ovarian hormones. So what is the cause of these changes? So these changes are mainly caused due to the level of pituitary and ovarian hormones. So here two types of hormones will play a very important role. First one is a pituitary hormone, which will be secreted by pituitary gland, and second type of hormone is the ovarian hormone, which is secreted by the ovary of the female. So in this diagram, you can see that the hypothalamus, it will release the hormone which is known as GnRH, gonadotropin releasing hormone. So this GnRH, it will stimulate the pituitary gland, and pituitary gland, it will produce two hormones, LH, and second hormone is FSH. And this LH and FSH, they will induce the ovary to for the for the to produce the mature graafian follicle, and simultaneously the proliferation of the endometrium will takes place. The secretion of gonadotropins LH and FSH increases gradually during the follicular phase. So during follicular phase, what will happen? The LH, luteinizing hormone, and FSH, follicle stimulating hormone. So the concentration or amount of these hormones, it will gradually increase. And these hormones stimulates follicular development as well as secretion of estrogen by the growing follicles. So these hormone LH and FSH, they will stimulate the ovary for the development of follicles. And these developing hormones, follicles, they will release a hormone, and that hormone is known as estrogen. So what is the source of this estrogen? So this estrogen, it will be secreted by the developing follicles inside the ovary. So in this diagram, it will be clear. So here, this particular, so this is a diagram of a diagrammatic presentation of various events during a menstrual cycle. So what are the different events which will takes place during the menstrual cycle? So this particular reason, so it is indicating the uterine events, mainly the endometrium. So how the wall of endometrium, it will undergoes during the different phases of the reproductive cycle. For example, that menstrual phase, so this is the thickening of the endometrium. During follicular phase, you can see the thickening of the endometrium, it is increasing. And finally, at luteal phase, so the thickness will be the maximum. In this particular part, we can see that the ovarian hormone levels. So what is the levels of ovarian hormone, estrogen and progesterone, during the different phases of the reproductive cycle? During the menstrual phase, we can clearly see that the level of the estrogen and progesterone is very less here. During follicular phase, the level of estrogen, it is increasing in this part, but the level of progesterone is still very less in the blood. And during the ovulatory phase, so this particular phase is the ovulatory phase. So this particular line, it is indicating the ovulatory phase. So in ovulatory phase, here we can clearly see that the level of estrogen, it is getting very increase here in the ovulatory phase. And again, in the luteal phase, the level of progesterone will decrease, but the level of progesterone will get increase. And this particular part, it is representing the ovarian events. So what are the different events which are taking place inside the ovary? So in this diagram, you can see the development of the mature graafian follicles from the primary follicle. It will transform into secondary follicle, tertiary follicle, and finally it will form the mature graafian follicle. And this graafian follicle, it will rupture to release the female gamete by the process called ovulation. And finally, this graafian follicle, it will transform into yellow mass of tissue, and this yellow mass of tissue is known as corpus luteum. In this particular part, we can see the pituitary hormones level. So pituitary gland, so it releases two hormones, FSH and LH. So mainly in this ovulatory phase, we can clearly see the level of LH, it is getting increased in the ovulatory phase. And this high level of increase of LH in ovulatory phase, this is known as LH surge. And due to this high level of LH in the blood, ovulation takes place. So both LH and FSH attain a peak level in the middle of cycle, about 14 days. So this both LH and FSH, they attain a peak roughly around the middle of the cycle, which is known as at middle of the cycle, about 14th day of the reproductive cycle. So rapid secretion of LH leading to its maximum level during the mid cycle called LH surge. So what is this LH surge? So the several fold increase in the secretion of LH at roughly at the mid cycle of the menstrual cycle. So this is known as LH surge, and this LH surge induces rupture of graafian follicle and thereby the release of ovum. So in this diagram, you can see the LH surge. The ovulation is followed by the last phase of the reproductive cycle, which is the luteal phase, during which the remaining part of the graafian follicle transform as the corpus luteum. So the remaining part of the graafian follicle, it will transform into yellow mass of tissue which is known as corpus luteum. So in this diagram you can see the corpus luteum. So this is the primordial follicle. It will form the primary follicle. From primary follicle, formation of secondary follicle, tertiary follicle, and ultimately the formation of graafian follicle takes place, and this graafian follicle will rupture, and this graafian follicle, it will transform into yellow mass of tissue which is known as corpus luteum. The corpus luteum secretes large amount of progesterone. So this is very important. So which hormone will be secreted by corpus luteum? So progesterone. And what is the use of this progesterone? So this progesterone is essential for maintenance of the endometrium. Such an endometrium is necessary for implantation. So why this endometrium is necessary? Suppose if the process of fertilization takes place, formation of zygote takes place, then this endometrium is necessary for the implantation. So this endometrium is necessary for implantation of the fertilized ovum and other events of pregnancy. So in this diagram you can see that if the fertilization takes place, then this zygote which will form the blastocyst and finally it will be implanted. So during pregnancy, all events of the menstrual cycle, it will stop and there is no menstruation. So this is also important. So during pregnancy, so all the events of the menstrual cycle, it will stop, and finally, so in the absence of fertilization, the corpus, what will happen to the corpus luteum? So this corpus luteum, it will degenerates. This cause disintegration of the endometrium leading to menstruation, marking a new cycle. In human beings, menstrual cycle stops around 50 years of age. That is termed as menopause. Cyclic menstruation is an indicator of normal reproductive phase and extends between menarche and menopause. Thank you. Now with the help of animation video, we will try to revise this topic.
There are three phases in the life of a living organism: juvenile, reproductive, and senescence. During the reproductive phase, organisms give birth to offspring. Interestingly, most organisms display certain morphological and physiological changes during the reproductive phase. Human females, for instance, experience the menstrual cycle, which is defined as cyclical changes in the genital system during the reproductive phase. Incidentally, a woman experiences her first menstrual cycle, called the menarche, at the onset of puberty, usually between the ages of 9 and 12. Occurring approximately every 28 days, a single menstrual cycle consists of four phases: menstrual phase, follicular or proliferative phase, ovulatory phase, and lastly, the luteal or secretory phase. Each phase of the menstrual cycle is marked by simultaneous changes in the uterus, ovary, and the secretion of hormones. For instance, during the menstrual phase, the endometrial lining of the uterus and its blood vessels break down and mix with blood, mucus, and other cell debris to form menses. The menses are discharged through the vagina as menstruation or menstrual flow, which lasts for 3 to 5 days from the beginning of the menstrual cycle. Interestingly, the absence of menstruation indicates pregnancy or ovarian disorders such as polycystic ovarian disorder, or even factors such as stress and ill health. The menstrual phase is followed by the follicular phase, which occurs between days 6 and 14 of the menstrual cycle. During this phase, the primary follicle in the ovary matures into a graafian follicle. Simultaneously, the endometrium undergoes proliferation, a process of regeneration which results in the formation of a new, thick endometrium. The follicular phase is followed by the ovulatory phase, which occurs during the middle of each menstrual cycle. During this phase, the graafian follicle ruptures to release an ovum or egg cell into the pelvic cavity in a process called ovulation. The ovulatory phase is succeeded by the luteal or secretory phase, the last phase of the menstrual cycle, which occurs between days 16 and 28 of the menstrual cycle. This phase sees the transformation of the remaining graafian follicle into a yellow mass called the corpus luteum. The endometrium too thickens, and its blood vessels become coiled and enlarged. Interestingly, the endometrium and corpus luteum play a vital role during the early stages of conception. For instance, a fertilized egg gets embedded in the endometrium and derives nourishment from it. The corpus luteum, on the other hand, starts secreting progesterone that helps maintain the endometrium and encourages the growth of the developing embryo. Conversely, in the absence of fertilization, the corpus luteum degenerates and triggers the breakdown of the endometrium. This marks the start of menstruation and the beginning of a new menstrual cycle. Did you know that the phases of the menstrual cycle are controlled by the interplay of different hormones secreted by the ovary and the pituitary gland? At the onset of menses, the anterior pituitary gland increases the secretion of the two gonadotropic hormones, luteinizing hormone or LH and follicle stimulating hormone or FSH, that simulate the development of primary follicles. However, the amount of estrogen and progesterone released by the ovary during this time is less, which causes the thinning of the endometrium. The release of LH and FSH keeps increasing, and during the follicular stage, these two hormones stimulate the maturation of the primary follicle into the graafian follicle. Moreover, LH and FSH stimulate the maturing follicles to release estrogen, a hormone that helps in the proliferation of the endometrium. The increased levels of estrogen, in turn, cause the anterior pituitary gland to release a surge of LH and FSH. So much so, that by the ovulation stage, the levels of FSH and LH in the blood are at their peak. This LH surge causes ovulation by rupturing the graafian follicle and turning the follicle's remnants into the corpus luteum. The estrogen level in the body too reaches its peak, and we see a gradual thickening of the endometrium. However, once the corpus luteum begins secreting large amounts of progesterone, an FSH and LH inhibiting hormone, the levels of both these hormones drop, which in turn also lowers the levels of estrogen in the body. However, the endometrium continues to thicken because of an increase in the level of progesterone. Incidentally, the corpus luteum will keep secreting progesterone if a fertilized egg gets embedded in the endometrium. However, in the absence of a fertilized egg, the corpus luteum stops releasing progesterone and degenerates. A drop in the level of progesterone in turn triggers menstruation as well as the restart of the release of LH and FSH by the pituitary gland. Menstrual cycles normally stop once a woman reaches her 50s. This phase is called menopause. The menstrual cycle is an important process in a woman's body, and it consists of four phases, which are controlled by hormones released by the ovary and the pituitary gland.